This is WSTV, Channel 4, Katrina, New York.
And now, it's the 1983 Winter Olympic Games, presented by WBS. Get that stupid music off of here! Get that music! Stop that music! This is the 1983 Winter Olympic Games, sponsored by WBS. Yes, that's right. WBS presents to you the Winter Olympic Games live, that's right, live from Katona, New York. I mean, Lake Placid. And while we're here, we'll be, we have the contestants out there right now. They're working on the track. And while we're out there, I'd like to introduce myself. I am Michael Gigalagatra. Yes, I'm your new announcer here at WBS, new sports announcer. And we'll be having... We're now going to introduce the contestants. We're now going to introduce the contestants. Here is Brian Chiknaka for Russia. There is Michael Likinach for Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia, that's right. There he is, Michael Chiknaka. And for the USA, Errol Cooney. Errol Cooney, and I'm sure all of you out there are rooting for him. And we're going to have it starting in a few minutes, and the event is, of course, the worldwide famous, the tobogganing, sledding downhill. That's right. We've already had the qualifying rounds, and these are the contestants that have won the qualifying rounds. And, well, we're going to be getting started here in just a second while they work on the track. They're discussing the condition of the track. The condition looks very good for this event today. Let's see, they're discussing. Still working on the track slightly, a little bit. And, let's see. Well, I think they decided to keep working. They're working on that track. They wanted to get it in top condition. That's right, Olympic certified. Olympically certified. Because, you know, that could mean the whole game, the whole competition right there is the condition of the track. You can see them shoveling the fake, snow. And, see how they're doing there. And they're doing all right, it looks like. The track is in excellent condition, I believe, right now, as you can see. They've had a heavy snowstorm. And, well, I think they'll be starting any second now. I think they've decided to play. The judges will be deciding when they should play. As you can see, it's a very jam-packed crowd. Yeah, they're all over the stadium. You can't see them in the camera, but they're really all over, crowding all around, trying to see. Yes, get a mic down there. You can hear them. Yeah, there they are, the American fans. Oh, well, it looks like they're going to start because, well, there's Errol Cooney with his sled has started. Now, take a look at Michael Leachick's sled there. I mean, he has got the best sled, I'd say, by far in the competition. Brian Janarsk has a Russian-made sled. It's like a circle. And anyway, they're getting ready. They've gone up the hill. You can see them, and now they're wishing each other good luck. They're talking to each other, saying, and the order will be Brian Ganarsk will be going first for the Russians. Then Michael Chiksikis will be coming down for the Czechoslovakians. And then, of course, our own Errol Cooney, whom everyone is rooting for the U.S. United States of America, I should say. And, well, they're down there. I guess they're getting ready. Yes, I see them. I'm up in the booth. They're up there. They're shaking hands, wishing each other good luck. That's great sportsmanship there. Oh, they've lost their footing. Oh, God. I hope they're okay. Wait, they're getting up. Yes, it looks like they're okay. Yes, okay. Well, Brian Ganarsk is okay. Michael Chink Sneaks is getting up. Yes, he'll be all right, I'm sure. Just a little off all there. And, well, we're beginning to start the play, I think. Brian Ganarsk will be starting for the Russians. There he gives his wave to his homeland as he goes down the treacherous mountainside. He's getting ready. The crowd goes tense. Here it is. Brian Cooney's first slide. This is the first round. The first slide of the day, folks. Here he goes. This is Brian Cooney. The judges will be scoring from 1 to 10. That's it, giving him numbers, from 1 to 10. There he goes. Oh, it looks like a beautiful slide. Yes. Oh, no. That's going to hurt him. Those points, they're going to have to take some points off for that. Let's see. He gets a 5. Not very good. That really hurt him that last time. Uh-oh, he's hurt. He's hurt down there. They're going to have to get the paramedics down. The paramedics, here they come. They get down there in a hurry. They've got to try to get him out. They'll have the second sled be coming down. There is the second sled now. They've got to try to get him out. Oh, no, the second sled is crushed in there. Somebody's been trapped down there. I hope everybody's all right down there, I think. Wait a minute, they need some help down there. There's nobody down. There's no more paramedics. There aren't any paramedics left. Somebody's stuck down there. Brian Ganarsk has made it out, though. Yes, looks like Brian Ganarsk, the contestant, is out. The paramedics are stuck, though. Wait a minute. The paramedics look a little bit mad. Brian Ganarsk is going wild. There's a fight. There's a brawl down there. They both go down. I don't know. The other paramedics is screaming for help down there. Oh no, now it's turned into a snowball fight. Now they're really going after each other now. Wait a minute. They've broken off. Yes, they're shaking hands now. Yes, they're... Oh no. There they go again. And, well... That was Brian Cooney for the first round. He's has a 5. And here's Michael Slingleaks. He's taking his sled up now. He's got the best sled, I think, in this competition. And well, he'll be going up. Of course, Brian Ganarsk got a 5. Not very good. And let's see what Michael Knisk can do. He wants to do well, of course. But he certainly wants to get better than a 5 to beat Byron Cooney in this first round. Of course, Errol Cooney will be following Michael Gnieksk. So he's getting ready. He's going up the hill now to get in back of him. So Michael Gnieksk is getting ready. The judges are getting ready. The crowd is getting ready. Let's see what happens in this first round of play. There you see Michael Gnieksk is getting ready. And you see his head down. He's getting ready. And, well, a little more preparation he needs, I guess. Yes, I see him down there. Yes, the camera's not picking him up, but I see him. He's getting ready. There he goes. There he goes. He's down the hill. What a perfect. That was perfect. So he curved down there at the end perfectly. Let's see what the judges give him. The judges say 8. That's an excellent score. And there goes Errol Cooney's. Errol Cooney's has an excellent slide. Excellent slide. And let's see what the judges give him. The judges give him a 9. Boy, what a first round there. That was a really exciting first round. Brian Cooney, Errol Cooney has gotten a 9, while the Czechoslovakian Michael Gnieksk has gotten an 8. Boy, two great slides. Here's the second round, the beginning of the second round. Brian Gnieksk has gone, oh no, that really hurts him. He goes down in the same place. It looks like he's stuck again. That's just terrible. Well, the first round score, the paramedics would get down there. First round score is Brian Cooney with a 5. There they go. There are the paramedics going down. Oh, no, the paramedic sled has crashed into the wreck. Oh, no, there's a wreck down there. The second paramedic sled will be coming down any minute. The rescue dog is down there. Hopefully he can pull them out. Wait a minute. He's attacking them. Oh, no. Well, I hope both of them can get out all right. Here comes the second paramedic. Looks like Brian Gnieksk has just made it out. He's collapsed onto the ground here in Lake Placid. The second paramedic is just sitting there while the rescue dog pulls the first paramedic out of the ditch. And, well, let me give you the first round score. The first round score, Brian Gnieksk had a 5. Not very good for him, for the Russians. And for the Czechoslovakians, Michael Gnieksk got a 8. That was an excellent slide, so he's still very well in the competition, and since it's very early. And, of course, for the United States of America, Errol Cooney got a 9 to go ahead of the Russians and the Czechoslovakians. What, and he just had a superb slide over all of them. Even though the Czechoslovakians have the best sled, I believe, out there today. There's Michael Brian Gnieksk is a little bit angry with himself. He throws his sled to the ground. But anyway, now they're getting ready for the... this is still the second round because that was the second round... Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot to give the score for the second round of Brian Cooney. Brian Cooney gets a 4 from the judges. Not very good for him. That means he's got a 9. 9 is not enough. Since it's still early in the second round. I believe the Czechoslovakians will be next. That's Michael Gnieksk. Oh, no, it's a terrible slide for him. Oh, God, that really ruins it for him. Let's see what he gets. Oh, no, he gets a 2. There goes Errol Cooney, a perfect slide for the United States. Let's see. Michael Gnieksk gets a 2. That gives him a 10. Errol Cooney gets another 9. That gives him 18. So, the score for the second round, the Russians have 9. The Czechoslovakians have 10, and the United States leads it with 18 here in this, after ending the second round of play. Here is Brian Gnarsk for the Russians with the third round. He finally gets it right. Oh, no, he falls in again. The paramedics are getting ready now again to go out there. Let's see who they give him. Another four. That's just horrible for the Russians. Wait a minute. He's waving the paramedics. Oh, the paramedics are coming anyway to the aid. There's the the paramedics. One of the paramedics is stuck into a gigantic bush there. Brian Gnarsk, meanwhile, is in pain, obvious pain. Second paramedic has gotten out. Brian Gnarsk appears to be all right. He's staggering a little bit, but I believe he'll be... Oh, God, he goes down. Let's see if they can do anything for him. I hope he can still be in this great match. So let's see, the Russians have 13. And after the third round of play, the Czechoslovakians and the United States still have to do the third round. Let's see, they're getting their first paramedic out of the bush. And he appears to be all right. So, we ought to be having, let's see, I don't know who next, I believe it'll be, Errol Cooney for the United States, who'll be coming up. Look, appears, the Czechoslovakians appear to have a, problem with the sled, so, I believe, Errol Cooney will be going, and they will have to skip the Czechoslovakians' turn. Czechoslovakians have 10, and they desperately need this turn, but since... little problem down there. They're a little bit weak, it appears. Czechoslovakians have a problem with the sled, so they have to skip the third round. Here is Errol Cooney for the United States getting ready. He'll be going down. He has an 18. This is his third round. Oh, it's not a very good slide for the Americans. He gets up to the side, though. He doesn't crash into the railing. He slides right along it. Get out of here, Charlie. Get out of here.
People, I don't know.
Anyway, boy, let's see what he gets. He gets a 6 from the Dutchess. Let's see what that gives him. That gives him a 24. A 24 after the third round. They skip the Czechoslovakians in the third round, and they get it. And so they, so far they have a 10, and the Russians come out with a 14. So the Americans appear to be winning here by a very comfortable margin. We will now go into the fourth round, I believe. Yes, now we're going into the fourth round. Brian Gnarsk for the Russians will be sliding. Let's see how he does. Hopefully he doesn't go down in that ditch. That has been a problem for him all day here. He keeps going in that ditch down there on the side, you can see. Right next up to the... There he goes. Let's see if he can do it this time. He's trying to stop himself with his hands, but no, he can't do it. Down in the ditch again he goes. So the paramedics will have to be called out again. For a third time, there's one paramedic. First paramedic hasn't come out yet, some problem. Well, there goes the sled. Appears to be no one in the sled. Crashes into... Oh, no. We have a little accident down there. That's a Czechoslovakian down there. And he's just gone down. As you saw, he must have been tumbling out of the sled down there, going down the hill. He's getting up slowly, though. Nope, he's down again. There's Errol Cooney for the United States. And Brian Gnarsk is still stuck in the ditch. Let's see if he can get himself out. I hope so. Hope he can still continue this. Although, the United States appears to be winning fairly easily. There's Brian Gnarsk. Oh, he goes down. Well, I hope these great contestants here will be able to get up because this has really been exciting. By the way, WBS's 1983 Winter Olympics have been sponsored by Budweiser, the beer that you love to drink. It's cool, refreshing. Have a Bud, even in the wintertime. And, the Czechoslovakians and the Russians appear to be hurt. I don't know, they could be disqualified. And since Errol Cooney is ahead, he would win. But they appear to be alright. As they come slowly walking up again, Brian Cooney for that fourth round score gets a 5. Not very good for the Russians. So that means, for the fourth round, the Russians have a 19. I believe that's right. Czechoslovakians still have a measly 10. And the United States has a 24. Oh, no, they both go down. There's Errol Cooney again with another perfect slide. Well, not quite as perfect. He gets an 8. So that gives him 32 after the fourth round. The United States has 32. Looks like they'll have to call the competition off because Czechoslovakians and the Russians are down. The United States wins it. That's right. There he is. The victor, Errol Cooney. The United States wins it by a very large margin. 32-19. Well, 32-19-10. I hope you have enjoyed this WBS sports presentation. Thank you. And, goodbye. This has been WBS.
stop the tape, please.